Good morning, everyone. Welcome to CAMEX 2021. Today, I will discuss the recycling of carbon fiber reinforced plastic by microwave pyrolysis. A little bit about me and my group. I'm the Director of Technical Innovation for Composite Materials at CTT Group. CTT Group is a research and development center that is specialized in technical textile-based product, prototyping and performance evaluation. We have up to 10,000 square feet facility, up to $15 million of equipment, 15 interns per year, 88 permanent employees, and we run more than 2,000 research and development projects per year. We are present in 8 segments of market as listed on the left. A little bit about PyroWave, that is our partner in this project. PyroWave is a pioneer in the electrification of chemical processes based on low carbon footprint microwaves. He's a leader in plastic, circular economy, and chemical recycling using the microwave technology. He's located in Montreal as well in Canada. The objective of this collaboration is actually to build a Canadian value chain that will promote the use of recycled carbon fiber whenever is possible. So we will have two axes. First, the implementation of an optimized carbon fiber reinforced plastic pyrolysis process based on the microwave technology. And secondly, the development of textile-based product made of recycled carbon fibers, such as yarn, hybrid yarn, non-woven. As you can see on the pictures, these are examples of product or derivative product that could be made of recycled carbon fibers. Now, the agenda for this presentation. First, I will present the problem, then the existing means of recovery. I will discuss a little bit about the microwave technology itself and the objective of this specific study, the methodology that we followed. I will present the result and the discussion and the conclusion and future work. Current demand of carbon fibers is estimated at 152,500 tons per year. North America holds 40% of that demand. It's estimated that in 2050, the demand will increase to 500,000 tons per year, and North America will still hold approximately thirds of 35% of that demand. We notice a systematic disposal of carbon fiber composite at the end of the life or during the production phase. So, for example, prepreg scraps, out of date rolls, out of tolerance part, tissues, etc. In the aerospace industry, for instance, at least 20% of the raw material is discarded and ends up in the landfill. Several techniques have been put forward to recover the fibers from CFRPs. Mechanical grinding, for example, will involve the mechanical grinding of the composite part and the reuse of the residue into different type of applications. Sometimes it can also feed a second step of transformation, depending on what will be the end application. Cementitious incineration, as the name indicates, is the incineration of the composite parts, and the residues are used for various applications as well. In that process, the mechanical performance of the residues are actually, the residues are not used for their mechanical performance because they are very, very low. And they will be used as reinforcements or fillers or for different applications in the cement industry. Solvolysis is the use of acid or some liquids in order to degrade the resin. Lately, there is also another process that is similar to solvolysis. It's a vapor thermolysis, and that process will use the steam of water at a certain pressure in order to degrade the matrix. Pyrolysis used less energy, and it was proven that with pyrolysis, we can actually obtain properties that are comparable to virgin fibers. Just to give an idea, it's possible to recover up to 90% of the mechanical performance of the fibers. Pyrolysis is the decomposition of the molecule under inert atmosphere at a temperature that will be between 400 and 1000 degrees Celsius. We have a conventional pyrolysis and a microwave pyrolysis. So the behavior is actually not the same. So in conventional heating, the heat will come from the outside. The material itself will be heated, but the all the components around actually in the environment. So that causes a lot of loss energy. While in the microwave heating, the principle is different. The material is heated and not the environment. And actually, the fact that there are three different behaviors of the material, when you use microwaves, you have materials that are that absorb microwaves, okay, such as carbon fibers, for example. You have materials that are transparent to microwaves, such as glass, quartz, etc. You have also materials that reflect the microwaves, such as metals. So this approach actually will enable the selectivity of the product that will be used in the process. For example, you can decide to eliminate all the reflecting materials, use all the transparent material in the setup, and only the material that is of interest will be actually absorbent, or you can also think of add a different absorbent if the material itself could not receive the microwaves easily. So this approach actually it's an opportunity for the dissemination. You can increase the selectivity of the product. The heating is rapid, uniform, and this is of a great interest. Now, the main objective of this study was to evaluate the technical feasibility of microwave pyrolysis on the CFRPs, and to see what are the highlights that could be provided at the laboratory scale. So step one, we did a TGA in order to assess the mass fraction of the resin in the composite part. This was our setup at step two. We used microwave applicator. The components actually were seated in the vessel, as we see, quad vessel. And on the right, these are the residues that were obtained. Step three, we analyzed the residue. We did a scanning electronic microscopy on the fibers, and the oils were analyzed by GCMS. The residue, the fiber residue were at the end also evaluated by TGA in order to assess the remaining resin quantity. So as a result, we were able to get rid of the resin in only 7 minutes of irradiation. We observed also that the, as you can see on the graph, there were some peak of temperature on the fibers during the pyrolysis. So we can ask ourselves, is these peaks will lower actually the mechanical properties of the fiber, of the recovered fibers. This we will evaluate that in the next steps of the study. So at the end, we were able to digest up to 90% of the resin. On the, as you can see on the TGA curves, before and after, the resin is completely gone. These are the scanning electronic microscopic observation on the recovered fibers. In fact, sample two shows a very good fiber surface. Okay, you can see that there are not that much resin left. Finally, on the oils, we identified 13 derivative products. These products actually, or the oils, could be used for different applications. So they can be used as accelerators, okay, in the formulation of some resins. They can be used as fillers in the compositions of virgin epoxies. It can also be used as a mixture in some fuels or used as an energy in the different other processes. In the conclusion, we noticed that this process was able to degrade more than 99% of the resin in only 7 minutes. The production is of recycled carbon fiber is much less expensive than production of virgin fibers, and also shows a very good low print carbon print footprint actually, 5 times less CO2 in comparison to virgin fibers, and this can actually be a good start of a solution to the problem of recycling of carbon fibers, plastics. So future work will focus on optimization of the microwave setup and parameters of pyrolysis, assessment of mechanical properties of recovered fibers, functionalization also of the recovered fibers in order to enhance the transfer load between the fibers and the matrix, and finally the development of textile products that will be made of recycled fibers, such as non-woven, hybrid yarn, and so on for structural applications. So I thank you all for your attention, and I will be glad to take any question. Thank you.